Hello, this is Laura Brandenburg from Bridging the Gap, and today I want to talk about a really important shift in the software industry that's impacting the business analysis role. And that's the introduction and the acceptance of more cloud-based solutions or software as a service, otherwise known as SaaS solutions. And Lisa asked a question about, you know, knowing that the industry and many companies now are opting to license these sorts of solutions rather than build custom software in-house, how does this affect the level of detail that I need to go through as a business analyst? It seems like I should be able to be a little bit less detailed about my requirements, right? And Lisa is totally correct. So let's talk about what the requirements process looks like on these kinds of projects. Right. It's not as necessary to get as detailed about the functional requirements of the software system because you're licensing something that's already been built, right? You don't have to specify in exact detail of what that thing needs to be. It's already built. That's part of what you're buying as an organization. So to invest a lot of time in specifying those details wouldn't make a lot of sense. However, there's still some really important requirements, deliverables, and pieces to put together, and they allow us to add even more value as a business analyst. So we're going to talk about three models: business process models, configuration and customization requirements, and then finally data models. So first, let's talk about business models. So when you are implementing that new system, it's probably replacing something that exists today or giving your organization functionality that it doesn't have today. And so that's going to impact your business processes. When we implemented a new shopping cart, we got some integration with our email management system, which allowed us to eliminate a bunch of manual processes that were in place today. And it also, you know, there were a few things that we had to do a little bit differently because of the way that orders were coming in. So we had to go and update those business processes. We had to eliminate some business processes, which is also a great thing from an efficiency standpoint. But if you never go back and actually do the work to figure out what you can eliminate, a lot of times business users will continue doing what they've always done and you won't really achieve that ROI on the project. So looking at how that business process is impacted by the new software is really important, as well as if there are new features that you're buying from that software that are going to add value to your organization, making sure your business processes are in place to actually use those features and receive that value in your organization. Okay, so second are the configuration and customization requirements. So most of the larger, more competitive tools available today offer some level of customization. It's not like just one thing and you have to use it as is. You can maybe add some custom fields or customize some workflows, choose how you link things together or display things on the user interface. So it's really important to walk through and understand the capabilities of that tool, and usually side by side with your business process, look at the tool and discuss those configuration options to make sure that you're configuring the tool to receive the most possible benefit from that tool for your organization. And configuration and customization are a little bit different. So configuration is what that tool enables out of the box. Customization is what you would add, you know, new functionality that would be specific to your organization. Usually you're going to pay for that. Not all tools even enable you to do that kind of customization. In that case, it's really just the same process as when you build new software in your organization. You're going to need those more detailed functional and visual requirements to make sure you're clearly communicating what you want that new system to do. Okay. Finally, let's talk about data modeling requirements, because these are extremely important when you are going into the cloud for a set of functionality. Because often you are going to, there's two sets of data requirements to be aware of. The first is the migration requirements. So is there any data that your organization manages today? It might be in a software system, might be in a spreadsheet or somebody's Access database, right? It might, who knows where that data is? That's part of the analysis process, is to figure out what data do we want to pull into that new system and how does that map over. And often that starts at a very high level, like, oh, we want our customer data to map over. We want our order data to map over. And then you get very granular. Oh, we need the customer name, the customer ID, you know, the customer address, and here are the specific fields that it's going to map to. So you want to definitely look at those data migration requirements. And then the second piece is that once that system is in place and running in your organization, are there any other systems that it needs to talk to? And that is called data integration or system integration requirements. So you want to look at the system you're using today. Does that talk to any systems? And if so, how do you replicate that using the new system? Or is there just an efficiency to be had by implementing an integration? Like when we built our new shopping cart, we got that integration with our email management system. And so that enabled us to eliminate a lot of business processes, but we also had to make sure we configured things to get that right. And so that was a big feature that we were choosing the shopping cart for, was the ability to do that. So we really paid attention to make sure that that integration point got right, got implemented correctly. So you want to look at those things as well. And sometimes you'll have to replace, you know, integrations that already exist today. Sometimes they'll just have to be updated to make sure they're working with the new system. Now, what we didn't talk about in this video are the selection criteria that you might use to choose one of these systems in the first place, because in many cases, it's not like there's just one solution. There's dozens of solutions out there, and you want to make sure you're choosing one that meets your business's needs, your security requirements, it's going to work within your workflow, have the key functionality you're looking for, integrate with your systems. It's a whole nother topic about choosing the right vendor or choosing the right tool. What we talked about today is once you've chosen a solution, what are the requirements analysis deliverables that you need to work through to make sure that you can implement that solution and deliver real value to your business. And just to recap, those were business process models, configuration and customization requirements, and data models. So again, Laura Brandenburg from Bridging the Gap, and we help mid-career professionals start business analyst careers. Thanks for watching.